It's the National Football League on EA Sports. And if it's in the game, it's in the game. It's the Los Angeles Chargers and the Green Bay Packers. Next on Madden Football.
The tundra may not quite be frozen, but it's getting there as we work our way through December. The radar today, however, is clear at Lambeau Field in Green Bay. Coming up, we got a good matchup on tap here, as it'll be the LA Chargers taking on the Green Bay Packers. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. CD, it is officially a new era here in Green Bay. After a few years of Willie Woney with Aaron Rodgers, it is officially time to see Jordan Love quarterbacking the Green Bay Packers.
And we'll find out what lessons he's absorbed along the way, how well he's mastered the playbook, the respect he's gained from his teammates in the locker room. We know that Love is in the air in Green Bay. The key is, what will Love do through the air?
Meanwhile, for the Chargers, you know, they have the pieces in place. They were a playoff team in 2022. What do you see for them this year?
You give this team full health throughout the season, and they have a chance to be not just a playoff team again, but beyond, because they'll scare the heck out of you on the offensive side of the ball. Defensively, that's where they have to start playing a little bit better.
Here's Anders Carlson set to get this one started, and we are underway here at Lambeau. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. So the Charger offense making its way out, and at the controls is the league's second leading passer a year ago. At 25 years of age, out of Oregon, it's Justin Herbert.
And it certainly hadn't taken Herbert long to earn his status as one of the league's best and most entertaining passers. Locked and loaded at every snap, and the second he sees an opening, that ball is soaring downfield. You better be on your toes against him on defense. The second you turn your head, they'll burn you.
Nowhere to go for Herbert, and he's going to go down. They could not contain Kenny Clark as he gets home for the sack. If they have any thoughts of coming in here and getting this road victory, that's not the way to start it out on the first play of the game.
Yeah, one thing you always say when you go on the road, take the crowd out of the game. They actually brought the crowd into it by permitting that sack right out of the gate.
Justin Herbert looking to throw on second down. On the screen, this is Eckler. A good pickup there, 18 yards as they get closer for third down.
That's a good bounce back play right there after taking a sack on first down. Didn't quite get it to the marker, but now they're in a much better spot for a third and short yardage call. If you're the offensive coordinator, you like looking at that section a heck of a lot better than trying to figure out third and long.
They'll try to pick up the first with Eckler. Boy, no chance as he was met and dropped behind the line there. It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up fourth down. So much for picking it up on the ground on third down. Third play of the drive, and this defense showing strong early.
I wonder how much of that was scouting. I wonder how much of that was a gut feeling like, okay, let's just go ahead and sell out here and get after them, thinking they're going to run the football and stuff them early, because they've now set the tone. They've set a precedent right here that if you're going to try and run the ball against us, it could be hard going throughout this game.
So here are the new-look Packers set to go to work. And at the helm here in 2023, a lot of eyes on this man in his fourth NFL season, Jordan Love.
And at the start of Jordan Love's NFL career, he had one of the best seats in the stadium watching Aaron Rodgers work. But now he's looking for more than that. Rocket arm, big play potential. And he wants to show this organization that he's capable of being a dependable starter for the foreseeable future.
Oh, an absolutely filthy joke. He's got some space now. And this will be a Packers first down as he's got this up to the 40-yard line.
That's a very nice game there. A confidence-building run. Love the execution up front. And the way he pressed the hole, absolutely perfect.
Love, they go play action now. That's complete to Dobbs. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And that will bring up second down.
Second down, six. At the 43-yard line.
Let's get out of here with the win, huh?
Love going to give this one to Jones. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and six. Defense able to get there, swarm to the football. Zilch, zero, nada there for the offense, Charles.
Yeah, it really was an example of good team defense, wasn't it? Everyone handled their responsibilities, and they held them to no gain.
Here's third and six. Love looking to throw it. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he's going to have a Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
What I love about watching the passing game nowadays is that the one-dimensional receiver is really starting to leave the game. You've got to be able to do it all. Of course, you got to run fast. Of course, you got to catch the ball. But route running savvy and toughness, there's a premium for all of that now.
On first and 10, Love got Dobbs over the middle. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
And I think this is a route we'll see more of as this game goes on, because with his speed, they want to get him the ball in space on drag routes just like this. They want him to get the ball and run after the catch. Good job there, though, holding him for a short gain.
In motion, left goes Watson. He'll get it here on the jet sweep. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down. Well, we've seen running backs in today's NFL get involved in the passing game. Maybe it's about time more receivers like that get involved in the running game.
And that is something we are seeing more and more in this league, no question about it. That wasn't the biggest of gains, but it was enough to get them a first down. And it continues to test the defense. They have to think on every play about who might end up with the ball.
A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Second down, another shot for Jones. And a nice move will yield nothing as he's stopped behind the line. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down.
Pretty straightforward play there by the linebacker. He saw the run, went with straight-ahead pursuit, and dumped him behind the line of scrimmage.
And they'll be in search of 6 yards here on third down. This is now the 9th play of the drive. Here's Love. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he's going to have the Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Really a solid start here on the opening drive, Charles. He's now 4-4, and they're already in plus territory.
Brandon, he's been so precise to start this game, like we're watching an operation taking place right now. Master surgeon at work.
From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Love. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. From the 3, second and a yard. Now the fourth-year man from B.C., it's A.J. Dillon. It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up first and goal.
Sometimes I get almost mesmerized watching these runners who have great vision. You know, those eyes that carry their feet to open spaces, make people miss. I just love watching those guys go to work.
Here we go now on first and goal. Dillon. Diving for the end zone, and he'll get there. Touchdown. So that a great sequence for these guys to begin the ball game. They force the punt on one end and come right down the field and score on the other.
And that's a great example of leaning on each other and building a little momentum that way. How about the defense forcing the punt? Turns it over to the offense with confidence, and they take it downfield and score.
Anders Carlson now for the point after. And it's good to make it 7-0 Packers. So that drive, 12 plays in length. And it was A.J. Dillon who capped it off with a touchdown run. Carlson back out there now to sim this one away. And he won't quite make it to the 25. The Chargers get set to go here for their second drive. And a three and out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out a little extra emotion. So now they get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive.
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go.
Second and 10. Herbert will give this one to Eckler. And he'll be stopped up at the 26 after a gain of only a couple.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going into the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Going to throw on third down with Herbert. He's got his target. That's complete. And he is going to have the Chargers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. He's got a man. That's Keenan Allen. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. They'll go down as a gain of 6, and that'll bring up second down. Out of the gun, Eckler running it. And he'll get it out to midfield. Let's say, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Well, you know they had a third down play on standby just in case, but he says no need with that carry. Runs like that will continually earn him more work in this and future contests.
First down, and they stick with Eckler. And that one blown up quickly. As he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. Big Kenny Clark that time pushing upfield to make the tackle for loss. Then our statistician Ben Ramsire just held up 3 fingers to remind me he now has 3 tackles for a loss rolling in the first quarter.
Well, Ben's got it detailed perfectly. He always gives us the right stats. I'd love to be on the offense's headset right now because what you're hearing is, can someone please block him? Come up with a scheme, come up with something. Make sure you block him because he's disrupting everything.
So the completion results there in 9 yards, and it brings up 3rd and 5 now. Now it's Herbert. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 29-yard line. 15 yards there for number 15. Setting up to throw on first down. And he's got it. Got his man on the end round. Complete. And he's going to be taken down right at the 10-yard line. So not quite a first and goal. It's 1st and 10 from the 10. Now a toss running left. Eckler. And he is going to lose yardage here. Rashawn Gary that time through the line and getting the tackle for loss.
Plays like we just saw there. That's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs or putting together a team, a lot of them say we're going to build from the inside out because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game. And that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
It'll be a gain of just a yard, and they'll be facing a third and 12. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Charger football to start quarter number two, as they've got it with a third down coming up. Herbert. And that is incomplete. So two third down conversions on this drive, but not able to get a third, and now they deal with fourth down.
They converted twice on third down that drive already, but couldn't make it a third. We always talk about in-game adjustments. How about what the defense did there, able to shut them down on that attempt?
And his kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So the margin shrinks there as they get the field goal to draw them a bit closer here in the second quarter.
Yeah, nice snap, nice hold. They just want to keep this game close, so give them credit for finishing that one off with three.
Here's Dicker now as he'll send this one away. Keyshawn Nixon now from his end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. The Packers offense here coming back out for their second drive. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Ball on the 30 now. Here's second and three. Play fake. Here's Love. Incomplete.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move them all over the place to try and find good matchups, and they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. Now Love. He's going to get that to his running back out of the backfield. And he's going to have the Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Short yardage situation, you have to wonder if they thought they were just going to run it inside. But you have to be cognizant of the back slipping out of the backfield trying to find some open space. And that's exactly what he does to the tune of a first down.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. To pass, here's Jordan Love. That's taken in by Kraft. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. A good pickup there, a 22.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius, understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball, and puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And he edges forward, but only gets a pair of yards out of it, and it's second down.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much.
So from the 37, here's a second and 8. On play action, Love to throw. He finds his man complete. That's Reed. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. Now a first and 10 at the 11.
Up the middle, Jones. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
A one-yard gain could look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
Off the play fake, Love. Out to his left. And he'll slide to a halt here, still a little shy of the first down marker. He'll end up getting five out of that, but now they're looking at third down.
They made a nice effort to stick him with a loss for that play, but it's going to take more than that to keep him from advancing the ball. Should be an entertaining battle anytime he tucks and runs over the second half of this contest.
To throw now, here's Love. Forced out to his, and he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Jordan Love, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Packers are able to extend their lead. Carlson on for the extra point. And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. That time, a 9-play drive. And it's finished off with a 5-yard touchdown run. So now Carlson, after the touchdown, called on to send this one away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20. Possession switching back now to the Chargers. They trail now 14-3, an 11-point deficit as they start things out with a first and 10. A throw left side to start the drive is complete. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
You don't always expect tight ends to be big in terms of run after the catch, but after that play, he joins a growing band of players that's putting that stereotype right on its ear.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Justin Herbert looking to pass. That's complete to the tight end, Everett. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. This duo locked in, 14 yards there, and a first down.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it, sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
Herbert's throw there complete to Allen. And he'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. 23 yards, the final tally.
Well, so far, little to no resistance by the defense on this drive alone. Three passes, three completions, three first downs. They're taking it to them, and it's paying off.
To the air again, Herbert. Complete. And the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves him with 2 to go on second down. So a decent gain there, but not their fourth consecutive first down like they had on the first 3 plays.
You sound almost disappointed there. You want to fire the offensive coordinator on that one or what?
They've gotten into a rhythm. I thought they were just going to keep going.
Well, almost a win for the defense, but if that's your win, you're not doing very well right now.
And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it leads to a first and goal.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Once more, here's Eckler. And he's going to press this one forward as they stop him right around the 1. Give him 4 on the carry there. It's second and goal.
It's largely been the air attack that's gotten them down here, but now's where you start to lean on that running game. That's a good pickup there on first and goal.
Second and goal from the one. Eckler. Touchdown, Chargers. So, partner, it was a passing game that drove them down the field, but when they get close, they trust that man in the backfield, and he took them home.
And they trust their offensive line as well, because so many of these units, they specialize in either pass protection or run blocking. This group shows its versatility and gets both done on this drive.
And for the extra point, Cameron Dicker. And he's got it. That cuts the lead. It's now 14-10. So this drive spans seven plays. And it's Austin Eckler who finishes things off with a touchdown run. So after the touchdown, here's Dicker out to kick this one off. And he returns this to the 22. Green Bay's offense ready to go again. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
Throw right side, hauled in by Dobbs. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down. Out of the shotgun, it's Jones. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now if you're a play caller, you could do just about anything you want. But on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
Rubs throw finds its target, Dobbs. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Catch number four for him on the afternoon, and it'll give him a first down.
Well, that's what you're looking for when you want to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
An inside give to Jones. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43.
And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved them and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
Line of scrimmage, the 43 on second and four. Love from the gun. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Reed. But following the play now, they're going to stop the clock here as a man is shaken up. Well, now they're going to come out and take a look at this injury, and we'll be back in a moment. The offense on third down tonight, a perfect 4-for-4 thus far. They're looking at third in the nose of the football. They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he's going to have a Packers first down as he's able to get about 3 that time on third and inches.
Brandon, they're still in the lead, but momentum's certainly been going the opposite direction. So to me, that's a really important pickup there on third down.
Try and regain some confidence, and you're right. They need to stem the tide a little bit. That certainly helped. And they'll keep on the ground with Jones. And he works his way free all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone. Give him 15 there, and the Packers have a first. Two minutes remaining in this first half of football. First down, going to the air with Love.
sideline. Throw caught by Dobbs. And he will reach the 5-yard line before going out of bounds. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
Boy, everything clicking on this drive. He's 4-for-4 now, and that throw, maybe the best of the bunch. This offense is really humming, and they pick up another first down.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Love now. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Down near the goal line, things really get physical. You're always anticipating a running play, but when they do throw it, things happen quickly. A little bit of a bang-bang play there that falls incomplete.
A line of scrimmage once again, the 5, as they get ready for second and goal. Throwing, Love. Touchdown, Packers! Romeo Dobbs, a 5-yard touchdown. And the Packers are able to stretch out their lead. So, Charles, that's 3 touchdowns on 3 drives, and it's just been an offensive barrage so far.
Great word, partner, using barrage right there. I'm going to add another word if you don't mind. How about perfection? No surprise that they're leading right now. Absolute dominance throughout this ball game, and no signs of slowing down.
Now Carlson for the extra point. It's good, and it's 21-10. So that one, a pretty time-consuming 10-play drive. And that drive all capped off with a Romeo Dobbs touchdown. So after the made field goal, here's Carlson to send it away. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. L.A. readies for its next possession. So remember, Charles, last time they were out here, they scored, but they just saw the opposition score, and they're trailing right now, so they're trying to keep pace here. They need a touchdown drive.
Well, if you're a fan of offense, you're loving this, but if you're a fan of defense, this is tough to watch, and it's also tough to keep that up when you just watch your opponent march down the field on a scoring drive that lasts into double-digit snaps. You need a score here, not just to follow the momentum from your last drive, but put the onus back on your opponent. And that's what they're doing right now, swapping that onus back and forth.
Here's a 2nd and 5 now from the 25. Out of the gun, Herbert. And this one is going to be off the mark, too far out in front.
One thing I have learned, receivers don't mind high throws so much to the sideline, but do that over the middle to them, and not only are the DBs going to throw a little verbal trash their way, when they get back to the huddle, they're going to have a few words to say to their QB, aren't they?
Yeah, hung out to dry a little bit there on the high throw. Luckily, fell incomplete. Back to throw here, Herbert. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. A gain there of 12 yards and a first down, L.A.
All right, let's just go ahead and walk through this one pretty easily, right? Blast off the line of scrimmage, get downfield to a certain point, usually around 8 to 10 yards, turn around and make sure the quarterback sees your numbers and set yourself up for the pass.
A well-executed curl route by Charles Davis. Now here's a pass on first down that's knocked away and incomplete.
A good job in coverage there. They took away his top read on the play, so he went through his progressions and ended up settling on his running back who scored on their last possession, but the coverage held. It goes incomplete.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. Here's Herbert. His throw incomplete.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because any completions on first and second down, now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. If you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Herbert now. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 42. Now a timeout called for by the offense.
as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. First and 10 here, and you know, if they could just get three out of this, something about whittling it to a one-score game at half that might provide a psychological boost. He's got his man. That's Everett, the tight end. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
That was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver. Although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice gain.
Herbert on first down now. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. He was looking for the Pro Bowl wideout Keenan Allen there. And that'll bring up second down. Now it's Herbert. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Now the Chargers will use the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. Approach this. Third down and 16 yards to go. Here's Herbert. Throw out wide. He's incomplete. So two third down conversions on this drive, but not able to get a third, and now they deal with fourth down.
Tight defense there on third down, but what a product of good coaching and even better execution because he realized he's in field goal range. No sense forcing anything, and he made sure he didn't.
And this one is right down the middle, and that'll make this an 8-point game. So a big play before the end of the half to get him into this spot, and they cash in with three.
How about the 1-2 to the solar plexus on that one? The big play, the field goal, not much time left on the clock. That's the way to go into the half.
Maybe time for one play on offense. 7 seconds to go in the half as the kick is away. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. All that remains is to snap this once, and that'll do it for the first half of play. So we're at halftime here at Lambeau with the Packers taking the lead to the break. As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, back to you guys in just a moment, but welcome everyone to our Creative Village Studios in the EA Sports Halftime Report. It was an excellent first half from quarterback Jordan Love. He had a touchdown both in the air and on the ground to help push his guys into the lead at the break.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. So it's the Packers set to receive the kick. They've got the lead as well as we are underway in the third quarter. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. The Packer offense ready to go to begin this third quarter. They're rocking and rolling, but the scoreboard doesn't show a big difference. You know, maybe it's one of those games where coaches say you can't miss your turn on offense.
I like the way you phrased it, especially with that. I love that rocking and rolling because the explosions on offense are happening. So that's going to get the crowd going. They're loving that. But defensively, they just can't get it together to get the stops they've needed in order to help increase their margin. They've got to find a way, but you're not counting on it. That's exactly what you said. Can't miss your turn, can't miss your opportunity.
Yeah, they're going for another opportunity now. Off the option, it's Jones. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. 59 yards rushing for him now as he's run it 11 times. They've got the lead early here in the third quarter, and runs like that are how they establish that lead in the first half.
I love the fact that you're using the word lead because they are leading from the front, pounding on the defense right now with the running game, and truly establishing themselves here in the second half.
They'll go again to Jones. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about four. Second and six.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Throw there by Law, pulled in by Reed. He continues to deliver a first down here. He had four catches in the first half, and this one number five. Love looking to throw it. And that one's going to come up a little short. It's incomplete.
I think he could have scanned downfield forever, but there wasn't anything available. Ends up throwing an incompletion, and I think he'll take that.
Now a second and 10. Now Love. That's complete to Wicks. They'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead. Again, it's Love. He had him. He was open, but he couldn't get it to him. It's incomplete.
That is certainly one way to frustrate a quarterback. Run those extra defenders on the field. Dime package, lots of speed, no space to fit in the football.
So off goes Love. On is Carlson for the Packer field goal. It'll come from the right hash. It's a 47-yard attempt. Kick is right there. It's good. And the lead now 11, 24-13. Well, they picked up right where they left off in the first half. First drive after the break, they come away with three and increase that lead.
Yeah, and you just want to keep building on that lead, don't you? Whether it's 6 points or 3 points, take everything you can get, keep maneuvering, keep adding to it, keep making it difficult for them to come back.
Carlson back out there now to send this one away. Taken at the goal line. And all deep in his own territory. He coughs up the football. And one of the linebackers has got it. And they'll be at the 18-yard line. Great field position here in the red zone. And now, as with every potential turnover, they're going to take a second look at this just to make sure. Now the question, was the knee in fact down before this ball comes loose? And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession of the football afterwards. This is a tough one to overturn.
So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. The Charger drive about to get going. And their deficit a little wider now than it was at halftime following the field goal a moment ago.
But the goal is still the same because you know they want to come out, establish a rhythm in the second half, and get going. Make no mistake about it, though. Kicking field goals, not in their game plan. They need to get the ball in the end zone.
And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's really a difficult task.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. Packer pressure, and down he goes. Devontae Wyatt with a big-time sack on third down. It's a loss of seven.
Well, how about that? A dime set on defense. Six defensive backs. None of them blitz. They're just back there in coverage. Defensive lineman gets the sack.
That's where the O-line, they go to the sideline, they keep their helmets on so the cameras can't find them, right?
Yeah, the cameras can't find them, but I know one thing, the O-line coach will.
A nice run back there off the good punt. It's a 16-yard return. And the Packers will have a short field to work with here as they take over first and 10. Play action this time with Love. Completed out left to Dobbs. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And that'll give him a short yardage situation here for second down. Running right, Jones. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it will go as a 1 yard loss, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Overall, I'd have to say that was just really good team defense because, to me, you can't pin that one on the running back. He had no shot there. He had a man in his face immediately.
Here now, third and a yard. Again, it's Jones. 68 yards rushing for him in the ball game now on 14 carries.
That's how you get right up off of the mat, because on the last play, they stoned him in the backfield and dropped him for a loss. But he's the type of guy that scared me a little bit because he's not daunted. Just got right back up, showed some confidence, and picked up a first down with his very next run.
A give to Jones. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up first and goal. Nothing too fancy, just a carry up the middle, but a successful carry up the middle against this 3-4 defense.
And to be able to do that, what do you have to control? The nose guard, right? Got to be able to move him. Otherwise, you're not getting anything up the middle. Nice job by the center. Got a little help from one of his friends playing guard.
Escape, and he's going to lose a yard or two. Taken down behind the line. Sebastian Joseph Day breaking through for the sack.
Well, there's still time to rectify this situation because the silver lining, it took a sack on first and goal. But that close to the goal line, that still definitely hurts.
Now from the 7, here's second and goal. The give is to Jones. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down.
Now, that was a terrific play. We're down here near the goal line, and only one word comes to mind for me, and that's overwhelm, because they absolutely overwhelmed the offensive line. He came free and made the hit in the backfield.
Love, this is third and goal. And this is going to be incomplete.
Great defense there on third and goal. They took away everything. Forced him to fire that one to the sideline where no one could get it.
So off goes Love. On is Carlson for the Packer field goal. This from 25 yards out. And this one is right through. And that will extend their lead even further. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to 3.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made them kick the field goal. And, yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
So now Carlson, after the touchdown, called on to send this one away. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. L.A. set to take over again on offense. These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least two first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
Here's second and 10. Herbert. Throws left side complete to Keenan Allen. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Herbert with a connection to Allen for a Charger first down. On play action, they'll throw. Underneath pass here to Van Ette. So give him 2 yards there on the completion, and it'll be second down.
I'm wondering if the same thing went through your mind as mine. When I see a big man like that make a catch, all I keep thinking to myself is, big man with football. Look out, everyone. He may not juke you a whole lot, right? He may not run past you because of his size. You're talking about a guy weighing in the 270 range. But boy, once he gets his mitts on the ball, he's going to be tough to bring down.
And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
What terrifies defenses when they see slant routes thrown is that the receiver is on the move, and oftentimes he catches it and gets upfield. Does a really nice job rallying to him and stopping him for a minimal gain.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Justin Herbert looking to pass. On the screen, this is Eckler. And oh, he's just going to be short here, barely. Maybe by a half a foot. It'll be fourth and inches.
Yeah, and on third down, you know those pass rushers, they're in the starter's block. They're just waiting for the pistol to fire. You can almost hear the defensive coaches on the sideline pre-snap. Watch the screen, watch the screen. Really good job there of identifying it and making the play to force fourth down.
On is the punter, Scott, here as he gets this one away. And the punt goes out of bounds. Where will they put it? They'll put it just inside the 45-yard line. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it, forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation prize. Like going to the county fair, you don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. Still a few inches short of a first down as they come up now on second down. They go bootleg. Love. A complete once again to Watson. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 13 yards, first down, Packers.
Second and short, that's a rundown, so it's definitely a good time to go play action if you're feeling it. And they do so and pick up a first down.
Lambeau Field, one of the best home field advantages in the NFL, no doubt. And they're a happy bunch here as the Packers lead third quarter. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right in the yard.
Well, if you like the guys who run the ball, you're enjoying watching this. But the other guys, especially the defense coordinator, trying to figure out an answer on how to slow down the running game, I think maybe starts to call more blitzes, because you can call run blitzes in order to try and get more people to the point of attack.
Love. He'll complete this one to Watson. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. Third catch for him on this drive alone, and it'll give him a first down. Here's Love. He finds his man, complete. It's Reed. He's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. As they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Just need a yard here, second and one. Back now at Lambeau. It's Packer football here as they've got the lead as well to begin the fourth quarter. The left side completion to Jones. And it looks like he'll be just a yard shy of the 5 here as he's out at the 6. A 5-yard gain there makes it first and goal. A good chance now to put this game on ice. This is first and goal. They will throw again here with Jordan Love. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
They may be snapping a ball near the goal line, but all you're thinking defensively, keep them out of the end zone. Force the incompletion, force them into going for 3 and not giving up 6.
They come up here with another shot from the 6-yard line, and it's second and goal now. From the shotgun, a give to Jones. And he gets halfway there from the 6 to the 3 on a gain of 3. This is kind of one of those in-between plays here, Charles, on third and goal from the 2 or the 3 in that area. What do you dial up?
Something quick hitting. You don't have the time for something that develops slowly. It's got to be right at them if you're going to run the football. And if you're going to throw it, something quick, get it out of your hands in a hurry.
And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Jordan Love, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Packers have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter. They were looking to pass the ball there, but they forgot to account for the man with the football.
Yeah, I can hear people right now saying, well, why don't you have a spy in your defense, someone who will dance with him and go where he goes? Well, oftentimes, if you utilize a spy, you've taken away someone in coverage as well. And oftentimes, the spy, not as athletic as the guy he's trying to keep up with, so he gets defeated anyway.
And he turns third and goal into a touchdown. So after the made field goal, here's Carlson to send it away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The LA offense ready for this next possession. Over on the sideline, hoping to hit that reset button between possessions. Last time out, they had to punt it away. This time, hoping to finish this thing off in the end zone. They throw right away, and that's complete out on the right side. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave them with a second and just a few inches left. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
Here's Herbert now on second down. A little short pass. This is Everett. That catch puts him over 70 yards receiving now as he's got a first down.
When an offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because they should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback, a hot route, so to speak.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Eckler now between the tackles. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
That was a good run, and it got to the second level. And what I mean by that is that's where the linebackers usually play, first level being the defensive front, last level being the secondary. But the strong safety position ended up making the tackle,
And oftentimes, we call them a hybrid. Combination defensive back, combination linebacker. We saw the linebacker make the stop.
Meanwhile, Herbert's this throw taken in by Johnston. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 39. The Chargers passing game rolling a bit here. They've got another first. So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 39-yard line. Back to throw here, Herbert. And that one complete downfield to Allen. And all the way in for a Charger touchdown. Keenan Allen, 39 yards. And the Chargers have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth. So a little bit of a letdown there defensively. I mean, look, you're still two scores to the good, CD, but things may be a little more uncomfortable than they had hoped.
Yeah, if you'd kept them out of the end zone there, this game's over. You've locked the door on them. Instead, it's still open a little bit, and they've got a puncher's chance.
Dicker now to tack on the extra point. And the lead will be cut down to 14. So the drive there, five plays, 80 yards. And it was Keenan Allen who finished it all off with the touchdown reception. Now after the Dicker field goal, he's back out ready to send it away. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. Now there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs to keep up with your theme there, playing keep away. First downs, they can't touch the ball.
It'll only be a loss of a couple, but the pressure gets home on first down. Well, you don't usually get a sack from a nose tackle spot, but we got one there.
No, we don't. And a lot of the times in passing situations, they end up off the field anyway. So how happy was he to work his way back to the quarterback and put him on the ground? He's going to end up with a nickname after something like that, some big jelly or something like that.
And they'll get to him quickly here as he'll get a yard, just a yard to the 22. The Packers on third down. Can't fault these numbers. 7 for 9 thus far. This is third and 11. Looking deep here for Dobbs. That's caught inside the 20. It's a big play there for Green Bay. 63 yards.
And this is seemingly how it's been all game long. This defense has been just a step too slow. And here they're burned again. Another big play.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Love now. And he's not able to get away. Sacked back at the 22. Tui Pelotu got in and dropped him.
I know there'll be a little bit of criticism there because they went right back to the air after the huge pickup and end up getting sacked. That's often a play that you make. You feel like you've got momentum on your side.
Unfortunately, the O-line failed to hold up to try to keep that momentum going. Throwing. Love. Open man left side. It's the tight end, DeGuara. They'll give him 4 yards there, and it'll be a third and about 13.
That was a nice throw out there to the flat, but they defended that pretty well. The hope is to go ahead and put it on him so he can turn and get upfield and gain additional yardage. There just wasn't anywhere to go on that play.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
I'm going to need some help with this one. How did he miss it? Wide open in the end zone. He's not hurried. He's not hit. And somehow, incomplete?
Yeah.
What happened?
During film study, that's one where he's just going to shake his head, not be able to believe it.
6 points go by the wayside on that one.
And his kick here is good. And that will extend their lead even further. So that almost certainly the final piece to this puzzle, a 3-score lead. I don't think there's any coming back from there.
But you know, normally I'd get on you for giving up on the game right here, but I do think you're right in this case. This late in the game, 2 scores is tough enough. 3, I'm with you. That seems out of the question.
Carlson back out there now to send this one away. This taken in at the goal line. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. The Charger defensive unit making their way back out there. And the complexion of this one has really changed a fair amount. That last field goal makes it a 3-score game, so they need points in a hurry with time dwindling in the fourth quarter. Here's Eckler to begin the drive. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe 3.
Defenses always talk about earning the right to rush the passer on third down. And you know what offenses want? Win first down so they can set things up for themselves better.
And that wasn't helpful there. Not a big impact on first down. From the 21, here's second down at 7. Here's Herbert.
I can assure you, setting up a screen is much more difficult than it appears. It requires excellent timing from everyone on the offense, and a defense's number one goal is to throw that timing off.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on 2nd down. From the shotgun, here's Herbert. Pass to the sideline and pulled in. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. A pickup of 24 on the 3rd down conversion. Los Angeles. On 1st down, it's Herbert. A little short pass. This is Everett. Short completion, just 4 yards, and it's 2nd down.
It's vitally important to wrap him up immediately, because if you let that big guy get ahead of steam up, boy, then you've got real trouble trying to get him down.
But they're able to hold him to a short gain on 1st down.
From just shy of midfield, here's 2nd and 6.
To the air again, Herbert. Wide open, it's Allen, complete. And this is going to result in another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Packers 35. The Chargers passing game rolling a bit here. They've got another 1st. So into Packer territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 35-yard line. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. Now a quick throw there, but it's going to be incomplete.
The coverage was good, but I just wonder if they absolutely fooled the quarterback on that play. I think he was expecting something else. Ended up with nowhere to throw the football successfully.
Here's 2nd and 10 now from the 35. Here's Herbert. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And this is going to result in another 1st down as the tackle's made at the Packers 17-yard line. The Chargers passing game rolling a bit here. They've got another 1st.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision, and receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
Herbert operating from the red zone. Got a man
it's Allen for the Charger touchdown. Keenan Allen with now two fourth quarter touchdowns.
And the Chargers are able to cut into that deficit.
He has his.
And we remember, of course, all scoring plays need to be verified upstairs. And I think they're going to at least take a look at this. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How is the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Extra point up and good by Dicker,
and the lead is trimmed down to 10. Two scores down, three timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. Oh, the Chargers are pointing, and they've got it.
The Charger drive about to get going. And the complexion of this one has changed a fair amount. That last field goal made it a two-score game, so they need to get points out of this drive relatively quickly.
A pass there over the middle to start things out, and he's brought down. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. A good start there on this fourth quarter drive. They need more of what we just saw.
Down a couple of scores. There's still time, all right? It's not like, you know, they're totally out of it, but they have to score quickly, and they're going to need some big-time plays, chunk plays, explosive plays. They need yardage on each snap.
That's caught inside the 20. And he's brought down after a very nice game. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
Charles, he's now over 400 yards passing in this one. It feels like he has a zillion completions. Just a very memorable effort from a guy that we thought could be in line for a big game, and he has exceeded our expectations.
That he has, and I'm not really surprised at all.
Open man, it's Johnston. Touchdown, Chargers.
An 18-yard touchdown grab.
And the Chargers have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. Well executed there offensively. Defense looked a little confused, but he found his receiver, and that one good for 6 points.
And the payoff we just saw there tells us how many times they ran this play in practice over the past few weeks, because they executed that flawlessly right here on game day when the situation arose.
Extra point up and good by Dicker.
And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter.
Here's Dicker now as he'll send this one away. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Green Bay about set for another series. Here comes Romeo Doubs.
They have to like what they've gotten from him in this game.
Think about the accumulation of catches.
Eight.
The yards per catch now, because you're getting more than a first down every time he's touching the ball. This is the kind of game you want when you're able to.
There he goes, right side. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard game.
I just love how they're going about trying to finish off this game. This is not an offense that's going to go into a shell. They're going to keep exploiting weaknesses where they see them. And that's a huge pickup there with the game in the balance.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off.
5 points of contact necessary at this stage as they'll run on first down.
And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line.
You know what we need, baby.
Let's go.
Second and 12, and you'd have to assume another all-out effort to stop the run is coming.
He's going to get it again. Just looking to get forward and protect the ball.
And quickly, we're going to get another stop here with 1:54 left as they call the timeout defensively. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. Now Love. He's got his target. That's complete. Chargers going to use their third and final timeout. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Take a knee. Second and 11. Love gonna give this one to Jones.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
So he'll take a knee here to wrap this one up, and he's going to want to keep that game ball. He was sensational. Well, taking that knee, maybe just a sigh of relief. They withstood a big fourth quarter comeback, able to hold on, though.
Certainly looked like they had things going their way, didn't it? In the fourth quarter, they had to just hold on. As you said, furious assault on them, but they were able to get it done, take a knee, and head to the locker room with a win.
And the kick is good, so you wonder how this one might be remembered the next time these two teams meet. But until then, this game's over.
Charles, normally when you see a group score this many points, it's a complete blowout, but instead they needed every single one of those in this close, high-scoring affair.
And Brandon, I'm still on the edge of my seat after that one, because when you have that much scoring and it still comes down to one possession game at the end, that's not something we see very often. In this case, these offenses, they brought it. The defenses, they're gonna need some work going forward.
So that'll do it for us. For my partner, Charles Davis, and all the hard-working men and women on our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL right here on EA Sports. The Packers are winners here as we say so long from Lambeau.